Here we're going to evaluate the partial derivative of Cp with respect to pressure at constant temperature. And we want to end up with a result that's only in terms of pressure and volume and temperature so we could apply it to an equation state, determine how heat capacity for, say, the van der Waals equation state depends on pressure. What we're going to do is start out with an exact differential of the enthalpy. I can write that as the partial of H, respect to temperature, and constant pressure, times dT, and then the partial of H with respect to pressure at constant temperature, dP. Now, you can see why I might want to start with this, because it's our definition of heat capacity, change in enthalpy with temperature at constant pressure. And now we're going to want to calculate this second term. Then what we're going to do is apply a Maxwell relation. We're going to take the derivative of this heat capacity with respect to pressure at constant temperature and take the derivative of this term on the right, once we determine what it is, respect to temperature at constant pressure. I'm going to set those two second derivatives equal to determine the heat capacity change with pressure at constant temperature. Get this term on the right, let's go back to the first law. I'm going to write the first law for a reversible process. Because it's reversible, dq reversible is T dS, and work for reversible process P dV. Now I'm going to make an additional substitution, and certainly if you just looked at this problem from the beginning, it would not be obvious which of the steps to follow. It's only after already knowing the procedure that I can directly go to them, and so you should keep that in mind in terms of solving these type of problems. What I'm going to do is write the definition of dH, dU plus dPV, and then what I want to do is expand the second term, so this is PdV plus VdP. And so now I'm going to take my term for du and substitute it here. So I've made that substitution, and then what you're going to notice is these two terms are going to cancel. So I end up with dH is equal to TdS plus VdP. So what I want to do next is apply the expansion rule to this equation. So I'm going to pause and first rewrite the equation so I have room to apply this. Now notice I've rewritten it as partials, and now I can remember the expansion rule. What it looks like I'm doing is dividing by partial respect to P, and I'm going to do this at constant temperature. That's not actually what I'm doing, but the actual calculation from calculus looks like that, so that's a way for us to remember it. And of course, this derivative of P respect to P is 1, so I can rewrite this. And then I can take this and substitute back in here, so I have an expression for dH. So let me rewrite this equation now with the substitution. This is the term now that we still need to put in terms of pressure, volume, and temperature, and I can use a Maxwell relationship, and so I'm not going to derive that, but we can look up the Maxwell relationship, which is that the partial of S respect to pressure at constant temperature is equal to minus the partial volume with respect to temperature at constant pressure. And now we've put things in terms of just pressure, volume, and temperature, so we can use an equation state. So this is a Maxwell relationship, and now I'll make this substitution. And so now we're close to where we originally headed, and that's, if we remember, if we look at this equation, Cp is the partial of H respect to temperature at constant pressure. And this term is the partial of H respect to pressure at constant temperature. And so we know if we were now to take another derivative, differentiate this respect to pressure at constant temperature, it's going to be the same as differentiating this term respect to temperature at constant pressure. Those two terms are equal because they both correspond to the second derivative respect to temperature, respect to pressure, and the order of differentiation doesn't matter. So that means now we have an expression, the partial of Cp, respect to pressure, at constant temperature, that's what we were originally set out to solve for, is the partial respect to T of the term in brackets. Right, so this is just saying the second derivatives are equal. So now I can start differentiation. I'm going to have to use the chain rule. So minus T, the second derivative V, respect to T, constant pressure, minus the first derivative V, respect to T, at constant pressure, and the derivative T with respect to T, which of course is going to be equal to 1, plus the derivative of V, respect to T, and forgot to write here, this is all derivative respect to temperature, pressure constant. So I can simplify this term on the right, and because this term is 1, notice then that this is just a negative of this, and so we're going to end up with minus T, the second derivative of volume, respect to temperature, constant pressure, is how the heat capacity for real gas changes pressure at constant temperature. This was our original goal. We can now take an equation of state, do this derivative. And so let's use the ideal gas law, where V, or specific volume, V is RT over P, and the derivative V, respect to T, at constant pressure, is just R to constant P is a constant. And then the second derivative V, respect to T, at constant pressure, then it's derivative of the constant, so that's 0. And so this says, for ideal gas, so remember this is ideal gas result. For ideal gas, heat capacity does not depend on pressure, only depends on temperature.